In the previous two videos, we have studied different types of table section for matching between Z-load and Z-node. We have studied exponential table section, we have studied triangular table section, and also we have studied Kolfenstein table section. Now in this video, we are going to present an example for designing such table section for matching specific load impedance to specific transmission line with specific characteristic impedance Z node. So it is required to design triangular table section, an exponential table section, and a Kolfenstein table section. The Kolfenstein table section is characterized by gamma maximum equals 0.02. to match a 50 ohm load to a 100 ohm line. This means that Z load would be 50 ohm and the characteristic impedance would be 100 ohms. If we are talking about triangular table section, the characteristic impedance Z as a function of the length of the transmission lines small z, it would be z naught multiplied by e to the power 2 z over l squared multiplied by ln z l over z naught. This for z greater than 0 and less than or equals l over 2 means that the first half starting from the transmission line. Then in the second half, the characteristic impedance would vary as e to the power 4 z over l minus 2 z squared over l squared minus 1 multiplied by ln z l over z naught, where z l would be 100 ohms, z naught would be z naught would be 100 ohms, and z l would be 50 ohms. Okay. And this is the variable would be z over l, starting from z over l to be 0 to 1, such that at z equals 0, z over l would be 0, at l, z over l it would be unit. Okay. In this case, the reflection coefficient gamma as a function of theta, where theta is beta l, equals half ln z l over z naught, ln 50 over 100, multiplied by sine beta l over 2 over beta l over 2 squared. Beta l here is corresponding to theta, or the phase shift c. And actually, beta is 2 pi over lambda, so beta l is 2 pi over lambda multiplied by l. For the case of exponential table section, the characteristic impedance is simply z as a function of the length z equals z naught multiplied by e to the power a z, where the value of a is determined as a equals 1 over the length multiplied by ln ZL over Z naught. So we can say that if we are going to call this A dash, for example, where A dash is A dash multiplied by Z over L, so A dash it would be ln ZL over Z naught. Ln ZL over Z naught is 0.693. In this case, the reflection coefficient, the magnitude of the reflection coefficient as a function of beta l, it would be half ln z l over z naught. Instead of sinc squared, it would be sinc beta l over beta l. Should be noted here this beta l over 2, here this beta l. Okay. For the case of Kolfenstein table section, we are going to calculate the coefficient A based on gamma maximum or maximum allowed reflection coefficient, and gamma naught, which is a reflection coefficient from z low to z low. Gamma naught is given by half ln zl over z naught, which is actually the approximation of zl minus z naught over zl plus z naught, right? And this value is nearly 0.346. Gamma m, it has been determined in the specification as 0.02. So the value of capital A is 3.543. This means that the Klopfenstein table section will satisfy that the reflection coefficient is less than or equal the maximum allowable reflection coefficient when beta L is greater than or equals A. From this, we can determine the value of the minimum value of L for the required Klopfenstein table section. So, the passband for Klopfenstein table section is defined as beta L is greater than or equal A, and we already have determined A. In the previous case, for the triangular table section, the passband starts from beta L over 2 equals pi over 2. So, beta L equals pi, or greater than or equal pi. Beta L greater than or equal pi, it means that the value of L is 2 lambda. The value of L is lambda. Sorry, the value of L is lambda. And for the exponential table section, the passband starts when beta L is greater than or equal pi over 2. So here, for triangular, the passband starts when beta L is greater than or equal pi. For exponential, when beta L is greater than or equal pi over 2. Pi over 2 is 1.57, so on. So according to this, it can be noted that for Klopfenstein table section, the passband start at smaller L than the exponential, than the triangular, but slightly greater than the exponential. That's what we'll see in the result. According to this, the reflection coefficient gamma as a function of beta L for Klopfenstein table section is given by gamma naught, which has already been calculated, multiplied by cosine square root beta L squared minus A squared over cosine A, assuming that the value of beta L is greater than A. If beta L is less than or in stop band, it would be cosine A squared minus beta L squared over cosine A. Okay? The value of the characteristic impedance for Klopfenstein table section is determined from this relation, the logarithm of the characteristic impedance as a function of length z equals half ln z naught multiplied by zl plus gamma naught over cosine a multiplied by a squared multiplied by the function phi of argument 2z over l minus 1 and a, where the function phi as a function of x and a is given by the integration from 0 to x, the modified Bessel function of first order I1 of a multiplied by square root 1 minus y squared over a multiplied by square root 1 minus y squared dy, where the magnitude of x or the magnitude of the argument, the first argument, should be less than or equal 1. Right? By using this relation, we can obtain the characteristic impedance as a function of z. By drawing the characteristic impedance for the different types of table section, we can see that this dot line corresponds to the exponential table section. It starts from Z load until to reach Z node. Okay. On the other hand, for triangular table section, for triangular table section, the function of the triangular table section draw this dashed line. It can be noted here that at the first half, the rate of change of the triangular table section is slower than the exponential. But at higher or at L greater than L over 2, the rate of change is greater than the exponential. For the case of Klopfenstein table section, the solid line, it is interesting to note that at the two ends, at the end of the load and the end of the transmission line, it is neither Z load or Z node. This means that the characteristic impedance of the Klopfenstein table section does not reach exactly the value of Z load at the load, neither Z node at the transmission line. This is not the situation in the exponential or triangular exponential function. Okay? Now, let us draw the corresponding reflection coefficient as a function of beta L or as a function of theta. For the case of exponential table section, we find out that the magnitude of the reflection coefficient is proportional to sinc function. So the envelope or the magnitude of the reflection coefficient is decaying as a sinc function. However, for triangular table section, it is proportional to sinc squared. For the case of sinc squared, the peaks are less than the peak of the sinc. So the peaks of sinc square are less than the peak of the sinc. On the other hand, for Klopfenstein table section, the solid line, we can note that the maximum allowable reflection coefficient is 0.02. We have already reached this condition at the value 1.13y. So, in the case of Klopfenstein table section, we are not talking about the first null. We are talking about when we already reached the condition of gamma maximum or the allowable gamma maximum. Okay? By comparing the different types, we can note that for the exponential table section, we obtain the first null for the reflection coefficient when beta L equals bar. Beta L equals bar corresponds to L equal lambda over 2. On the other hand, for the case of triangular table section, we obtain the first null of the reflection coefficient when beta L equals 2 bar. This corresponds to L equals lambda. However, for Klopfenstein table section, we obtain the condition for reflection coefficient gamma less than or equal gamma m, which is maximum allowable reflection coefficient, at a value slightly greater than by and less than 2 by. This means that the required length for Kolfenstein timber section is slightly greater than the required for exponential timber section, which is the minimum one, and less than the required section for triangular expansion, triangular timber section. In addition, if you looked at the maximum or gamma maximum, we can note that the gamma maximum here is nearly the same as the case of triangular timber section. This means that by using Kolfenstein timber section, we obtain reflection coefficient equals or less than the reflection coefficient of triangular, and the reflection coefficient of triangular is actually less than the reflection coefficient of exponential, and at the same time we have obtained this small reflection coefficient in the case of Kolfenstein timber section, but minimum length of the timber section. This actually the main advantage of Kolfenstein timber section. It introduces small reflection with using small light, right? That's what we are seeing here. The Kolfenstein timber gives a desired response of magnitude of reflection coefficient is less than or equal maximum allowable reflection coefficient gamma m, which equals 0.02 in our case, for beta l greater than or equals 1.13 by, which is smaller than the corresponding length of either triangular or exponential timber section. So we have a great advantage of Kolfenstein timber section that it can obtain minimum reflection coefficient with minimum length of timber section. Also, it can be noted that like step Chebyshev matching transformer, the response of Kolfenstein timber section has equal ripple. If we are looking at the ripple of Kolfenstein timber section, we can note that the ripples are the same. In the case of the sinc function, the amplitude of the reflection coefficient is decaying 1 over x. For the case of the triangular timber section, which has property of sinc squared is proportional to 1 over x squared. But here we have equal ripple, so it is constant. So in this case, regardless what is the frequency, the reflection coefficient would be the same as long as we have or we have a frequency greater than the bus band of Kolfenstein timber section. This means that Kolfenstein timber section is the optimum timber section if we are looking for the length and constant reflection coefficient. By this end, we have completed the timber section matching network, and we also completed chapter 5 of matching and tuning circuits for microwave circuits. Okay, see you in next chapter, chapter 6, which is basically talking about the resonators in microwave. All right.